Happy Thursday! Today we're playing more Bioshock, as you're probably not that surprised. Given that this is the game that I've been playing for the past month and a half. 2 months. But, yeah. I'm excited. Elizabeth has just conjured a rail. I'm sure this isn't going to go badly at all. So let's get going. Uh-oh. It goes through... Oh, there you are! Hey! Oh, you look... Oh, that's not good. This is not good. Not good. Oh! Weren't you supposed to be docile? This is not what I wanted to come back to! Hey, she saved me! Elizabeth, you're not a bad person! I mean, you weren't a bad person anyway, and I don't think that you would have been a bad person if you didn't save me. Because I'm a bad person. She's like, no, that's your limit. That's your limit.
Just need to supply enough weapons to arm an entire uprising.
And where will we get these weapons? From one of our many friends and allies?
A gunsmith in Finkton should be a walk in the park. What do you say, partners?
You're a liar, Mr. DeWitt. And a thug.
I'm glad we understand each other.
Only means reaching Paris.
Oh my god, I love Elizabeth so much. Because she's like a sensible, rational human in a world that is totally chaotic and weird. And when I'm a jerk, which is basically always, she calls me out. I'm turning over a new leaf. Elizabeth is working with me. I want to honor her trust. I don't want to... Oh, hell with it. I just really like shooting racist cops.
I would be your gunsmith. Who sent you to find this person?
Daisy Fitzroy.
She's either a great hero or the worst of scoundrels.
Hey guys. You're gonna get really upset if I like... I think I want to save up for some weapon mods. You're gonna really get really upset if I like... Bam out the vending machine. It's cool. I'm just a man with a waving around a gun.
Welcome to Fink Industries Recruitment. We are not looking for any help. Did you hear that? Not help.
How are we going to get into Finkton?
Illegally. Let's look for another way.
Yeah.
Elizabeth.
Done.
I missed you, Elizabeth. It wasn't as fun being a maniac when you're not around to be my balancing influence. Hi, do you mind if I take this off your desk? No, you... Yeah, you do! Oh, God! Thank you. Your chief problem is that you have heads. I will fix that for you. Could you solve my problems for a bit? I'm not digging this burst gun thing. I would much rather have a machine gun. Oh my god! Oh right, I forgot about that part. Okay, I understand that I have an upgrade to this thing that makes human enemies kill themselves at the end of it. But I was somehow not expecting that man to beat himself to death. Oh. That's a thing that happened.
Can you open this, Elizabeth?
Okay. Oh, wow. I wish I had not seen that, but at the same time, having seen that, I don't feel comfortable using his power anymore. He just beat himself to death. I'm a monster. Oh. More lockpicks. Good. I was running out, I think. Oh, there's a vending machine guy over here. Oh, it's an armory guy, too. Awesome. I will take the money that's in your cabinets, because you keep it there, even though they're like... Alright, carbine damage boost. Shotgun damage. Volley gun damage. Pistol ammo increase. That seems legit. Carbine clip. Sniper rifle recoil. I think we have enough for the pistol ammo and the machine gun one. Yeah. So now my machine gun has a clip of 122 and my pistol ammo is much higher. Sweet. I'm digging this pistol. This is where I came in. Service elevator to Finkton.
Fancy putting those
lock picks. All right, 7 lockpicks. That's good. Well, 6 now. So that whole altercation started, I think, because I took that thing off a guy's desk, but I would like to think that it was going to happen anyway. I was... Oh. Is this,
seems right up your alley.
It requires 5 picks. Wow. This had better be good.
Wanna hold on to
Oh, there's an infusion in here. Let's get another shield. Some more shields.
Nice.
Should get some more salts, too. Repeater ammo. My hand cannon ammo is now full, but I haven't found a hand cannon yet. Have you just scrounged up a thing? Salts. Okay. So, let's find a service elevator. Don't mind me. I'm just a crazy murderer. Searching through your stuff. And eating your beans. This seems important. Late.
I hold in my hand.
Do you work here?
The private journal of Comstock's wife. It puts the lie to this miracle child nonsense. She loved the child not. It seems the sainted lady would have preferred to let the seed of the prophet just dry out on the bedsheets.
Oh dear. Well, that was effing cold. Also, I'm going to double check my options to make sure that I have subtitles for all of that stuff. It looks like I do. He wasn't subtitled, so...
The most common complaint I hear from the working man is that they are unhappy with their lot.
Bro tap!
Why to adventure, yeah. I ask? The ox cannot become a lion, and why would you want to? Lots all those responsibilities and worry.
This is my mother's diary.
You eat your food.
Why would Slate have?
You go to sleep.
Husband claims the child is created from his cloth. Believer, but I am not a fool. His bastard shall not be raised under this roof. My mother. She had me locked.
That's some pretty dark stuff,
Elizabeth.
I just want to get out of this.
I want to ring this bell.
Please.
I want to ring it so bad. Anyway. Oh, elevator. Awesome. What, no elevator music? Oh, here we are. Propaganda.
Maya Thick, and I want to share with you my personal creed. What is the most admirable creature on God's green earth? Why, it's the bee.
Bees!
Have you ever seen a bee take a sick day?
Oh, God.
The answer is no. So I say, bee... The bee.
That's terrifying. Have you ever seen a bee take a sick day? No, but in winter, when they die, other bees push their corpses out to the edges of the hive to add to their... If this guy says, would you kindly anything, that's it. We're done. Table flipped. Anyway, bees push the corpses of other bees out to the edges of hives.
Yes.
Alter Mr. Fink, please.
What?
DeWitt, Fink here. Listen, my boy, we've had our eye on you, and I can tell you right now that you are our top candidate. Top! Now, my associate, Mr. Flambeau, will help you with anything you need.
What the hell was that?
Mr. Flambeau sounds like a fire guy that I'm going
to
have to shoot.
To make your acquaintance.
I'm uncomfortable with my no gun. This guy owns a whole town. That's terrifying. I feel like if your question is ever, should I build a giant statue of myself? The answer is no. I would go as far as saying,
now, some say to me,
should I...
You
should anyone build a statue of me? No. You should build statues of, like, dead people.
Well, I'll tell you what. I'll be damned if I let any poor folk get robbed at some shady establishment. You see, the Fink Company store brings you Fink products
at Fink prices.
Designed specifically for the Fink worker.
The Walmart economy. This is, like... This is some oh ho.
Variety of supplies here that should see you through your visit.
You look attractive.
What does Mr. Fink want with us?
Excuse me, miss, but Mr. Fink's interest is strictly in the
Okay, so
but why?
So sorry. Yeah. But any questions regarding
Oh, baby girl. We're gonna switch it for my machine gun, just cause my pistol is like my most reliable gun, and this hand cannon doesn't have a lot of ammo. But damn. Also, are you my guy? Yeah, probably. What is going on?
I've been
nine.
Nine.
6 beat, now 8.
7.5.
7.5.
6 minutes and 15 seconds.
6 minutes and 5.
5 minutes 50. I can do 5 and 50.
5 and 50. I said 5 and 50. Anyone know that 5
What's
and 50?
What's going on?
Cole Porter goes to the worker in the blue shirt.
So the whole point of it is they the lowest bid on the job is
14.
Oh my god, this is like complicated labor relations stuff. Like, this is the lowest bid on a job gets the job, but you have to say, you know, I mean, you have to make the case for, you know what, fuck it. Oh, I feel better now. Yes, I do have a deep-seated sense of class warfare, and F it. Hi. Oh, man. Yeah, like, that makes me deeply uncomfortable. Hi. Remember to use your vigors. Translation, it has been a while since you were using those cool-ass supernatural powers we gave you. Have you thought about them? Anyway, I wanted to go to the clock shop. I just feel really good about shooting that guy. Ooh. Where's the oh, good time. There we are. The clock. Oh no, good time. Like, as in good time. Not as in like clock, like clocks, but like have a good time. The gunsmith Chen Lin is over here.
Is a trickster. They live to stir up trouble. So you beware the hyena. They will leave you.
Man, with all this and oh, that is the clock store. Okay. It's got a big clock on it. Sure, okay. We'll go in here. This seems fun. Yeah, so anyway, yeah, the whole bidding on work thing, that deeply bothers me in a lot of ways, apparently. And, you get really mad. I mean, that was, there were some feels there. I'm working class at heart. And the notion that you would create a structural system that encourages people to trivialize their labor, makes me really angry. Give me the money. I don't feel bad about shooting that guy at all. Hand cannon upgrades? Hand cannon upgrades? Oh.
Here's some cash. Okay.
Yeah. Cannon ammo versus burst gun ammo, a shotgun. This is literally just like a resupply. Is there nothing else in here? Get the money. It does look that way. All right. Well, at least it'll be quieter out here. Although there are still those, machine guns. Oh, rotten apple hurt me. That's intriguing. I've never... Food shouldn't hurt me. Credence. I suspect you're right. It's a good freaking song, though. Can we go to the dimension with the rockin' music? So we got Devil's Kiss Aid, we got Devil Kiss Boost, we got Bronco Aid. I don't know, I have enough for the Bronco Aid. I don't get a lot of use of the Bronco anyway. Probably because I don't use my Vigors nearly enough! Hop! Oh, Chen Lin Gunsmith. That seems useful. Bam! Hi, everybody. What's in your barrel? Oh, cake barrel. Cake. Barrel cake. Mm. Toolbox pineapple. Oh. Great. Mmm. Hand cannon ammo. Enter the gunsmith shop. It's interesting that, to me, it is interesting that the notion of Finktown bothers me far more than the notion of Columbia in general and the sort of racist overtones of Columbia. This is probably because, being who I am, I deal a lot more with relations. I experience class privilege more than I experience, certainly much more than I experience racial privilege, or any other kind of discrimination. Like, class is the thing that hits me most often because I am me. Because I'm not a visible minority, because I'm not, like, it's... That is the kind of discrimination that gets me. It's not more... I was about to say it's not more or less important than other kinds of discrimination. I mean, the whole point of intersectionality and theories of intersectionality is that oppression and discrimination change your relationship to them based on who you are and where you are in life. So, I mean... Working class black people. Yes, I would like some money. Thank you. Experience oppression differently than working class white people and that kind of thing. And it invariably they experience more oppression. Yeah, come for the video games. Stay for the labor philosophy. Anyway, I probably got to go through that fire. You really want to read more about intersectionality, you can read some papers by Ann Gary, who is super cool and wrote a lot about it.
Someone tells me Comstock doesn't cater to idols getting worshipped.
I'm like, is that light or bullshit? That's light.
Hello, Mr. Lin, Chen Lin.
Do you know your own name? Are you here? I'm busy looking in this, in these crates for sandwiches. Oh, dear. Hello.
Excuse me.
Everything's fine.
We're looking for Mr. Lin. Mr. Chen Lin.
Mr. Lin, not here.
It never occurs to Booker that Chen Lin could be a lady. I would like to think that for the voice direction for Mei Lin, They were like, no. You need to be more of a stereotypical Chinese person. You need to... No. Your English is too good. That's your problem here. Oh, now I go to the Good Time Club. Details. I wouldn't worry so much about it, Elizabeth. We're gonna go to a place. I'm gonna shoot everyone. We will profit. But we'll do that next week, I think. Because it is. Oh,
lock this. There's a lockpick over there.
Yeah, there is. But we're gonna do that next week because we've done enough work philosophy and labor philosophy and shooting people for today. And I will see you guys later. Yeah, I just shot an unarmed man in the back. What are you going to do about it? I think we've established that I have... No, actually, you guys are racist, so I think I still pretty much have the moral high ground in this one.